have been fully distributed. So there was nothing left in the other warehouse. But unfortunately, that was a compound containing warehouses for other private organizations, people selling electronics. And then these young men went out and continued to pilfer and loot. Our worry was, if we allow that situation to continue, you'd see, like we saw in Calabar today, instead of moving from, moving into homes to harass, And we cannot allow such a total breakdown of law and order. And as of this evening, I'm pleased to inform you that the security chiefs under my control undertook a counter-offensive. We were able to dispel the crowd. We've arrested quite a few of them. They're making useful statements as I speak to the police headquarters. And we pray that, this will bring some calmness into the state. And
Yes. in warehouses for times that are unprecedented. As a doctor, a public health physician, I know we have been expecting a second wave of COVID. I, if I was governor, and my team would be very, very unreliable and not on the point if I gave out every single palliative, knowing that a second wave may arise. So it was only clear that we prepare for the rainy day. And 5,000 from 1 million, that is more or less not a number to worry too much about. However, for our people out there right now, the governor has spoken to us. He don't talk and he don't tell us or time. However you want us to explain this, please let us be peaceful, let us be calm, and let us await events. Like you pointed out, this is not happening only just in Edo State. And it is his love and dedication to all of us. He holds all of us in high esteem. And he has chosen to come out and explain to us today. Your Excellency, I know you want the prayer to go on. I know you want us to go ahead with what was planned. But just before you go, I want you to tell us today that one prayer point you want all the men and women of God hearing gathered to take on your behalf, even by the time you have left this particular gathering just now, sir.